chairman of the board, and I really do serve at the service and pleasure of our chairman, of our founder, where'd he go? Jay Feinberg, the gentleman who has created all of us being here, has joined us this morning out of the cold, out of the warm environs of Boca Raton. Reggie, you gotta cut the feedback. To date, the Gift of Life walks have raised over $700,000, and I want to thank all of you for contributing to make that occur. Also, maybe more equally important is that we have swabbed enough people and created 80 transplants from everybody's participation. So there are 80 potential lives that have been saved by all of your efforts. A little quick information about Gift of Life. We're currently 242,000 people in our registry, 12,371 matches, and 2,914 transplants, which is also an astonishing number. Today, I want to encourage you to get swabbed. If you have not been swabbed to join our registry, you may do so. Where are my swabbing people? Over here. There they are, huddling. Also, we have blankets for donors. So if you are encouraged and inspired to write a note on a blanket to someone who is soon going to be donating their stem cells, that's a nice thing to do. And now I want to take a moment and introduce our official MC. It's Chris Gordon, formerly an attorney, the Emmy Award-winning Chris Gordon of NBC4 of Washington. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you all for being here. And I did a quick test, and I know for those standing over there in the shade, it's a little warmer over here in this little stream of sun. I want to say that I'm pleased to be here with you today, and everyone for joining us this morning for this wonderful life-saving cause. Now, I'm Chris Gordon from NBC4, and our slogan is Working for You. And so we come out to the community quite often for events like this, and I'm very pleased when I'm invited to participate, especially to be able to share with you the story that we're going to tell you this morning, a success story, a story about work, generosity, and giving. Now, when I was asked to do this, I read very quickly the email, and it said, can you MC at 7 o'clock? And I assumed it was 7 p.m. So I really do admire your courage for coming out here today and participating in this great cause. Well, today is an incredibly special day for two strangers who are here in our audience, one of which is alive today thanks to the generosity of the other. Phineas, can you and your family please come up and join me on stage? Right up here. So everyone can see you, and you can get ready for a wonderful surprise and a great meeting. I'd like to introduce you, as he steps up on stage, to 7-year-old Phineas. Let's give him a big round of applause and the whole family. That will also keep us warm. Now, like many boys his age, Phineas enjoys monster trucks, Legos, riding his bike, and building things. But in March of 2014, when Phineas was just 4 years old, he was diagnosed with high-risk lymphoblastic leukemia. The name itself is scary. Initially, he had gone to the doctor for a cold and fever, but when his mother saw that there was a rash on his chest, she immediately knew that it was leukemia. Sadly, the family had lost a daughter to leukemia in 2006, and Phineas's mother knew the signs all too well. When his family learned that Phineas would need a transplant in order to survive, the scenario was familiar, and it was frightening. They felt reassured when several great donor matches were quickly found, a sign of hope in this terrible situation. And after weeks of chemotherapy and total body radiation, Phineas had his transplant at the University of North Carolina Hospital in Chapel Hill, just minutes away from his home. They describe the transplant as a happy day, one they hoped represented the end to their nightmare. Well, with support from their community, their friends and their family, they received a good deal of help, companionship, and encouragement along the way. As Phineas began to recover, he was doing so well that his doctor joked that the donor must surely be a marathon runner because her cells were so healthy and strong. Well, how surprised they were when they received a card from the donor who mentioned she was training for a mini triathlon. Phineas is now enjoying being back at school where friends with friends, where he can focus on the important things in life, such as building with Legos, writing books, and laughing at his favorite jokes. They have something else written here. The people who know the kind of jokes you like. And the rest of you can imagine what a 7-year-old healthy boy likes to joke about. Phineas and his family have been waiting almost 2 years to say thank you to the stranger who was so willing to help them. They said that her gift means everything to them, and they're anxious to give her a big hug. Well, they hope today will begin a friendship that will last a lifetime. Phineas, your donor wants you to know that you are her hero. She thinks that you are incredibly brave, and there is not a day that goes by that she doesn't think about you and the special bond that you share. She is excited, nervous, and anxious, and happy to meet you today, and I bet you and your family feel the exact same way. Your donor is 25 years old. She lives in Raleigh, North Carolina. She joined Gift of Life's registry during her senior year at Allegheny College in Meadville, Pennsylvania in 2012. When she learned that she was a match for you, she was thrilled and she was overwhelmed by the feeling of wanting to help you in any way she could. She had lots of support from her family, her friends, and coworkers throughout the donation process, and she, of course, credits the amazing team at Gift of Life for keeping in constant contact, answering all of her questions along the way, and being, as she described, wonderful and amazing. Well, your donor has a message for the crowd gathered here today, and that is supporting Gift of Life, giving just what the name says, life, to both the donor and the recipient. She says that her experience as a donor has truly changed her approach to life each and every day. These opportunities can only happen thanks to the generosity of the individuals that you're looking at right here, and individuals across the country and across the years who have supported Gift of Life. Well, Phineas and his family, your donor declared her triathlon was dedicated to you, Phineas. And we know that she's ready to get going with today's walk. But before she gets up and runs up here on stage, she wants to finally get to meet you. And so it gives me the greatest pleasure at this moment to introduce you for the first time to your bone marrow donor, Ashley. Ashley, will you come up on stage? Ashley, Ashley, can you turn around so the cameras can see you as you hug Phineas? If you can give him a Ashley, could I have you come over just for a moment and say in your own words what this experience means, the donation and meeting for the first time, Phineas.
This is absolutely incredible. First and foremost, thank you everyone for coming out and everyone who organized this. 2 years ago, I donated, and honestly every single day. I think about you and him, and just hoping that he's getting healthier and stronger. And so being here with everyone is just absolutely incredible.
Well, Ashley, thank you for your generosity. Let's give her a big round of applause. And who will speak with Phineas or for Phineas? It's always the way. The mother says the dad, the dad says the mom. I'm going to hand this
one. Yeah.
Come on up here with me.
Sure. Yeah, thank you for showing up. I mean, just for showing up to get swabbed and really showing up to give yourselves to this guy. It's huge. You know, there's not enough time or words to tell you how much he means to us and this means to us. But good job on staying healthy, because this guy is just robust. And it's really strange. And first time we met you was a back of your bone marrow, you know, 2 years ago, hanging at UNC. So it's nice to finally see the rest of you and get to say hello. And what are you doing in North Carolina?
Yeah. I work at Red Hat.
Wow. So we'll have more time to talk then. Thank you so much.
Well, let me have you step right in front, all of you, so that the photographers can get the kind of pictures they need. Right up in front. In fact, let's step down into the sunshine so that we can get the best lighting. Phineas, can I just ask you something? Is today a good day?
Yeah.
What do you want to tell the people about this moment meeting Ashley? It's hard sometimes for words. And Mom?
I'm just so happy to be here, and it's a beautiful day.
What are your first names?
Carlos.
Tina. Fiona.
Fiona, how do you feel? And what are your thoughts?
I'm just extremely happy to be here and to finally meet Bardo.
Ashley, you've thought about this day for some time. How does it feel?
Incredible. Just happy and, I don't know, overjoyed, I guess.
All right, well, big hand, guys, big round of applause, right, and let me give it back to Bill. Because Bill knows what we're going to do next, and I don't.
So to my right, over that direction is where our start's going to be. After they take a few photos, we'll have them lead us.
Thank you.
Ashley,